Hey everyone, Joe here. In today's video, I want to show you how you can set up your Twitch alerts in OBS Studio 27. Now this is actually quite easy. The first thing you will need to do is go to streamlabs.com and set up an account. Don't worry, the account is free. Now once you get that done, it should automatically set up your account for whatever one you set up for. They have the options for YouTube, Twitch, Facebook, you know, if anybody uses that. And when you set up the account, if you go to settings under account and go down to account settings, like you see here on my screen, you should already automatically have your one set up, like Twitch, for example. However, if you want to also merge YouTube in with it, you can. It's quite easy. And once you got that done, the account part's set up, you're good to go. So let's go over here into the top where it says Stream Essentials and click on Alert Box. Okay, everybody. So we have alerts up here. Now, each one of these type alerts, your widgets and stuff, you can customize to various degrees. And we're only going to focus on alert box here. But if you go look at all your other widgets here, like your chat box, which a lot of people do use, as well as your event list and donation goals, and all these others are all set up exactly the same way. And all of them have various extents which you can customize them. Now, like I said, chat box is all right here, and event list, which are only the two biggest ones most people see. However, donation goals there as well. As you see, viewer account, media share, tip ticker, and so on. The only one that's actually different here is stream labels, and I'll get into another tutorial on it later on. So make sure you subscribe for that tutorial when it comes out. So, like I said, all these you can customize, so I'm not going to get into all these in detail. You can experiment in your own time. I'm just going to kind of show you how to actually set them up. Now, before I actually get back over here and click on alert box again, I do want to mention each one of these will have their own little URLs you'll have to paste into your OBS browser. Now, this is actually really easy. It might sound complicated, but I'll show you how to do that in a second. So just keep in mind when you set one of these up, you have to have a separate URL for each one of them. And each one of these little widgets provide their own URL. So easy, don't worry about it. Alert box, let's just focus on it at the moment since they're all exactly the same for the most part. All right, it says right here, widget URL. Now, all we got to do is simply copy that. But I do want to mention, you see all this other options down here? This is so you can customize them. All the alerts, all your events, all have their own different types of customization. So it's actually quite easy to set up. But like I said, we're just going to focus on actually how to put this into OBS at the moment. So like I said, it says widget URL. You see, it says click to show widget URL. I'm going to leave mine hidden because it's tied to my account. You don't want people seeing this. So I'm going to leave that blurred out. And actually, when I post it in OBS, I'm going to have to go in DaVinci Resolve and blur it out so you guys can see it. I don't think anybody really want to copy it, but it's just in case there are somebody who wants to do not so nice things with it. So anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and click copy, and it is copied over to my clipboard now, so you don't have to worry about that. And now we'll just hop over here to OBS Studio 27. Okay, everybody, so now we have OBS 27 open up here on the desktop. Now, a little pro tip, I recommend you take a screenshot of the game you're gonna be playing the most, and like, for example, for me, World of Warcraft, like you see here on the screen, and use it as a little temporary image to help kind of line up your alerts and stuff so your viewers can have the best viewing experience. So it might help you want to move something where it's not obscuring something you may want to be seen on the game a lot. Alrighty. So that being said, if you go down here, you see the little plus sign. Go ahead and click on that. And remember, we keep talking about the browser URLs. Well, right there is browser. Let's go ahead and click browser. And it's going to say create new. We can put in a name. I'm going to type in tutorial. And I'm going to type in alerts. All right. And click OK. And once we get this done, you said you've just added a browser source with the default dialogue here. Now, if you're adding a chat source, obviously you want the chat to cover more of the screen. You can change the height right here, put in like 1200. Now, I recommend that you always change the height and stuff right there and the width, and don't actually use your mouse cursor to size this any, because it can make your text look kind of blurry and won't look very nice. And as you notice by default, if you hit enter, it automatically closes the window. I have a nasty habit of doing that each time, and it's just very annoying. I wish OBS would change that. But that's another complaint for another day. Anyway, we put in back 600 here. And of course, you can't change anything to hit OK again, annoyingly. And let's go back to properties one more time. All right. I remember the URL we copied just a minute ago. All right. Right here where it says URL, where I just highlighted, is where you're going to paste that. So simply just hit Control V to paste that right over. Now, mine's blurred out here because I don't want everybody seeing it, obviously. But that's simply all you got to do. And just hit OK. Now you'll notice it did disappear on the screen. However, we can test this out to see how it looks. So now let's open up my browser again, open Chrome back up to Streamlabs' website where we was just at. Okay. And if you go back over here to where we're at, where it says alert box, you notice it says test follow. Let me click test follow. As you can see, it pops up on the screen. And we can click and drag this around anywhere we want to. So let me poke this up here, test subscription. And you can see mine's coming up. Now I'm using a custom graphic that I created myself. It's nothing fancy. Now I recommend you create your own later on, but just use the default ones until you get actually used to setting all this up. So you click on test donation and test them all. And yeah, that's simply how easy it is. And once you got it in the place you want, you can just simply hit the lock it down so we don't accidentally move it. And well, you're good to go. Okay, everybody. So that's how easy it is to set up alerts, chat overlays, and other Twitch stuff into OBS Studio 27. Now, like I mentioned, the only one that's really different here is stream labels. And well, I'll have a tutorial coming up for that in a few weeks. Make sure you subscribe for that. So anyway, that's it for this video, everyone. I hope you like it. If you did, how about give me a thumbs up? Thumbs up is always highly appreciated. Now, if you're not a subscriber to my channel yet, now's a great time to subscribe. Subscribe is free. It's for you. Let you know when I release more videos. Until next time, everyone, thank you for watching.